Good morning all of you. This video is basically continuation of my previously taught video of second chapter, that is matter around us pure? In that video, we discuss about matter on the basis of chemical properties. In that, we discuss about several parts of matters on the basis of chemical properties. As we know that on the basis of chemical properties, there are two type of matter is there, that is pure substance and mixture. So in that video, or we can say that in first video, we did detailed study of pure substance and some introduction of mixture. In that video, we discussed up to heterogeneous mixture. Now in this video, we will discuss some more topics of this chapter. So in this video, you will study the types of homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Second point is this: you will discuss about the comparative study of different types of solution on the basis of appearance. Third point is this: you will discuss about solution strength and concentration of solution and the numericals based on the solution. So let's just start with the topic solution. See, as we know that mixture is two type: homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Okay, homogeneous mixture is also a that type of a mixture in which distinct layer is not formed and we are not able to see the particles through naked eyes. Okay, similarly, heterogeneous mixture are that type of a mixture in which we are able to see distinct layer and we are able to see the particles through our naked eyes. On their division only we will study in this video. So let's just start with the topic solution, because solution is a part of homogeneous mixture as well as heterogeneous mixture. In general, solution is considered as homogeneous mixture which is formed by the combination of two or more components in either equal proportion or in a unequal proportion. Okay, it is consist of many phases, means either it is present in a liquid phase, solid phase or gaseous phase, any phase it is present. Basically, a solution is combination of solute plus solvent. Now what is solute? Solute is that component which is present in lesser amount in solution, and solvent is that component which is present in higher amount in solution. In other language, we can say that a solute is a chemical substance which get dissolved, and solvent is that substance which help in the dissolution of solute. That is known as a solute and solvent. Different type of solution is there. Different criteria are set to differentiate or to classify solution. So on the basis of appearance, solution is classified into three form. That is true solution, colloidal solution and suspension. So let's just start with true solution. What is true solution? True solution is basically a homogeneous mixture in that two or more component is present in either a fixed ratio or in a not fixed ratio, and basically it also consists of solute and solvent part. For example, salt in water, sugar in water, iodine in water, and likewise this many other things. Now that type of solution is known as a true solution. You will understand by this figure. Here one glass is there, in that one tablespoon of salt or sugar is get dissolved. After that dissolving, what you will see, you will observe, you will perform this experiment at your home also. You will get a clear solution. After seeing this, you are not able to identify whether that glass of water is having sugar in it or salt in it. Okay, after tasting only you are able to identify. So that type of solution is known as a true solution. Now what are the properties of true solution? There are many properties of true solution is there. First property of true solution is it is a homogeneous mixture. Particle cannot be seen through naked eyes. The solute cannot be separated by filtration. Means if nothing is visible in that, ki whether the solute is present in present or not, we are not able to do the filtration process. Fourth point is that the solute particle do not settle down and the solution is stable. And when we pass a beam of light, it will move in a straight direction. It will not go anywhere. It will not get scattered. So in simple language, we can say that ki Tyndall effect is not possible in true solution. Similarly, the next type of solution is colloidal solution. So let us just study what is colloidal solution. Colloidal solution is basically example of heterogeneous mixture. It is also formed by two or more substance. Just like true solution is example of homogeneous mixture. Similarly, colloidal solution and suspension is the example of heterogeneous mixture. So it is also formed by the combination of two or more substance. For example, a mixture of starch in water, a mixture of egg albumen in water, milk, air conditioning dust and smoke and etc. The very common and the simplest example which you are able to see in your house is that is a milk. Milk is a example of colloidal solution. Another example is that just take a wheat flour and dissolve in one glass of water. After some time, what you will observe that the color of the solution get changed. Why? Because some of the particle get dissolved in the solvent. Due to that, the overall color of solution get changed. And some particles are revolving along with the solution, along with the solvent only. So that type of solution is known as a colloidal solution. Now, what are the properties of colloidal solution? Colloidal solution is a heterogeneous mixture. The particle cannot be seen through a naked eyes. The solute particle cannot be separated by filtration process because the particles are so small that the filtration is not possible in colloidal solution. The particles do not settle down and the solution is stable. See, we cannot completely say that particles are not settled down. In some cases, the particle may settle down at the time of the preparation of colloidal solution, but in some cases it not get settled down. So we can say that sometime the particles in colloidal solution get settled down and sometime it will not get settled down. Similarly, sometime the filtration is possible, but after some time filtration is not possible in colloidal solution. The most important property of colloidal solution is that colloidal solution is showing the Tyndall effect property. What is Tyndall effect? The scattering of beam of light through colloidal solution is known as a Tyndall effect. So when we pass a beam of light through colloidal solution, what happen? The light get scattered in different direction, and this scattering of beam of light is known as a Tyndall effect. Now, some example of colloidal solution is here that foam, a shaving cream which our father and brothers are using to clean the beard, that is known example of colloidal solution. Milk, fog, smog, detergent, blood, all are the example of colloidal solution. Now, let's just discuss the different types of colloidal solution which we are observing in our day-to-day life. Types of colloidal solution or types of collides. There are basically 8 type of colloidal solution is there, or there are 8 type of collides are there. So, the first collide is salt. Second is emulsion. Third is foam. Fourth is solid salt. Fifth is solid emulsion. Sixth is solid foam. Seventh is solid aerosol. And last is liquid aerosol. Just like a solution, colloidal solution is also made up of two things. That is a dispersed phase एंड डिस्पर्स मीडियम. डिस्पर्स फेस इज जस्ट लाइक अ सॉल्यूट एंड डिस्पर्स मीडियम इज जस्ट लाइक अ सॉल्वेंट. डिस्पर्स फेस इज अ दैट फेस विच गेट डिसॉल्व एंड डिस्पर्स मीडियम इज अ दैट मीडियम इन विच द डिस्पर्स फेस इज गेट डिसॉल्व. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द डिफरेंट स्टेट ऑफ मैटर दीज एट कोलाइडल आर फॉर्म. सो फर्स्ट इज सॉल विच इज फॉर्म्ड बाई द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड. मीन्स वेन सॉलिड गेट डिजॉल्व इन लिक्विड सो दैट टाइप ऑफ मिक्सचर और सोल्यूशन इज नोन एज अ सॉल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पेंट फ्रूट जेलीज डाइज एंड एक्सेट्रा. सिमिलरली इमल्शन द सेकेंड कोलाइड इज इमल्शन. वेन बोथ dispersed phase and dispersed medium present in liquid state then that type of collide is known as a emulsion. Example of emulsion is mayonnaise which we used to apply on bread, milk, salad, cream. They all are the example of emulsion. Like the best example of emulsion is oil and water. When we take a mixture of oil and water that is the example of emulsion. When dispersed phase means just like a solute and dispersed medium just like a solvent is present in a liquid state so that time emulsion is formed. When sol is formed, when dispersed phase is present in solid form and dispersed medium is present in liquid form. Similarly foam, how foam is formed? When dispersed phase is present in a gaseous form and dispersed medium is present in a liquid form. Example is beer froth, soap, shirts, whipped cream, all are the example of foam. Solid salt, when both dispersed phase and dispersed medium present in a form of solid, like alloy, gemstone, ruby, glasses, colored glasses, which we used to see on our windows, that are the example of your solid salt. It is a type of collide only. Solid emulsion, when dispersed phase is present in a liquid form and dispersed medium is present in a solid form. Means when your solute is present in a form of liquid state and your solvent is present in a form of solid. So that is known as a solid emulsion. For example, butter, cheese, they are the example of solid emulsion. Solid form, when both dispersed phase is present in a gaseous form and dispersed medium is present in a solid form. For example, pumice, marshmallows, margins, they all are known as an example of solid form. Pumice, what is pumice? Pumice is a small soap-like stone which used to clean the dirty skin. It is mostly present and oftenly present in the washroom of anybody. Now, your seventh one is solid aerosol. When dispersed phase is solid and dispersed medium is gases. For example, smoke, dust, bacteria in air. Last is liquid aerosol. When dispersed phase is liquid and dispersed medium is gas. For example, fog, mist, cloud, spray, all are the example of liquid aerosol. So these are the eight types of collides which is formed by the combination of dispersed phase and dispersed medium. Dispersed phase and dispersed medium are different, and on that basis different collides are there. For example, sol, emulsion, form, solid, solid emulsion, solid form, solid aerosol, liquid aerosol, likewise this. So these are the types of collides. Now we will discuss about the third type of solution on the basis of appearance, that is suspension. Suspension is also a heterogeneous mixture of two or more substance. For example, like solution of sand and water, solution of chalk powder and water. See, it is a most common and simplest form of type of solution, or we can say that suspension is also considered as intermediate between two solution and colloidal solution. In that suspension, we are able to see clearly the distinct layer of one component to other component. Means we are able to identify the dissolving component in a particular solution. For example, सैंड इन वाटर, चॉक पाउडर इन वाटर. व्हेन वी जस्ट टेक अ सम अमाउंट ऑफ सैंड एंड डिजॉल्व इन वाटर, आफ्टर सम टाइम यू विल सी द सैंड गेट सेटल डाउन ऑन बॉटम एंड अपर साइड ऑफ द ग्लास क्लियर लिक्विड इज देयर. सो बाई डूइंग सो वी आर एबल टू सी, वी आर एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई इन अ दैट पर्टिक्युलर ग्लास सैंड एंड वॉटर इज प्रेजेंट. सिमिलरली इफ वी टेक चॉक पाउडर एंड डिजॉल्व इन वॉटर, वॉट विल हैपन? You will get two distinct layer, and by that two distinct layer you will identify ki what are the components are present. By this figure you will clearly understand. See, in the first glass some amount of soil is dissolved in water. After some time what will happen? The soil get deposited on the bottom of the glass, and on the upper side of the glass liquid is there. So that type of solution is known as a suspension. Now what are the properties of suspension? See, in the case of suspension the particle size is very big in comparison to colloidal solution and true solution. That's why we are able to see the particles of, or we can say that the particles of component of suspension through our naked eyes. Second, first thing is that suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. We all know the particle can be seen by the naked eyes. The solute particle can be separated by filtration particle because the particle size is very bigger. It will not pass through the filter paper. That's why it get deposited on filter paper and the filtration is possible. And after the filtration, you will get a clear liquid like the second figure. Fourth point is this, the solute particles settle down and the solution is unstable. The particles scattered a beam of light passing through it, and it light is visible in the solution. See, in both the cases, in a case of suspension also, we can say that scattering of beam of light is possible also or not possible also. When we pass a beam of light from upper side of the glass, then what will happen? We are able to see the beam of light passing in a straight direction. But when we pass the beam of light through the bottom of the glass, the light get scattered. So on that basis we can say that the suspension may or may not be show the Tyndall effect. So these are the properties of suspension. Now we will discuss the comparative study of suspension, colloidal and true solution. Along with that we will discuss some other different types of solution on the basis of concentration, on the basis of solvent. So let's just start. Before starting this, first let's just understand what is Tyndall effect. As we discussed already, Tyndall effect is a beam of light passing through a colloidal solution. The particles scattered the beam of light and the part of the light become visible in the solution, and this effect is called as a Tyndall effect. See, Tyndall effect can be seen when light enter a room through a small hole due to scattering of light by the dust and the smoke particles. See, just do one thing, just put curtains all over your room and switch off all the light and just open a little hole. So after some time you will see a beam of light is coming from that hole, and that is known as a Tyndall effect. You will see Tyndall effect in dense forest due to the scattering of light by the water droplet in the mist. So this is all about Tyndall effect. Now let's just do the comparative study of solution, colloids and suspension. Means in at a one place how we will differentiate solution from colloidal and suspension. So the particle type, in a case of solution, ions, atoms and molecules are present. See, the first property is that the particle type. So in solution, ions, atoms, small molecules are present. present. Means the particle size is very small in a form of ions and atoms and a smaller molecule which is not able to see through our naked eyes. Similarly, in case of collides, the larger molecules or particles are there, but they are not as large that we are able to see with our naked eyes. But in case of suspension, the particles are very big. That's why we are able to see through our naked eyes. Size of particle in case of solution or true solution, the particle size range bit 0.1 to 1 nanometer. In case of collide, it ranges from 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. And in case of suspension, it ranges between 1000 nanometer to more. Means they are present in a more bigger form. That's why we are able to see through our naked eyes. Now, effect of light. No scattering is possible. Collide exhibit Tyndall effect. Exhibit Tyndall effect, or sometime it will not exhibit Tyndall effect. So we can say that in true solution, Tyndall effect is not possible. Collidal, Tyndall effect is possible. And in suspension also, Tyndall effect is possible. Now, the effect of gravity. Stable does not get separated. Means the filtration is not possible in true solution because the particle size are very small. That's why the particle not get settled down on the bottom, and this makes the solution stable. Similarly, in case of collides also, the particle does not settle down on the bottom of the solution. That's why which make the collide stable in nature. But in case of suspension, they are unstable in nature and the particle gets settled down on the bottom, and that particles are known as a sediments. Now, filtration is not possible in true solution. In collidal solution also filtration is not possible, but in suspension filtration is possible. Uniformity. So true solution is homogeneous in nature. We are not able to see the components of true solution. Collidal solution, it's heterogeneous in nature, but in some cases we are not able to identify the component, but in some cases we are able to identify the component. And suspension also, it is also heterogeneous in nature. So these are the comparative differences between solution, collides and suspension. Now let's just discuss the different type of solution on the basis of their concentration and on the basis of the presence of solvent in it. So let's just see ki what the different types of solution are there that we already discussed. So what exactly they are, let's just see. Solution are different type based on the number of criteria, like the difference in the solute or the solvent. Let's look at the different type of solution based on the different criteria. So the first criteria is on the basis of water as a solvent. That as we all know that solution is a combination of solute and solvent. So when solvent is present in a form of water, then how many types of solution is there? So let's just see. Basically, when water is present in a form of solvent, so two type of solution is there, that is aqueous solution and non-aqueous solution. So let's just see what is aqueous solution. These solution have water as a solvent. For example, sugar in water, carbon dioxide in water. So whenever water is used as a solvent along with any other component, so that type of solution is known as a aqueous solution. This is the first criteria, that water as a solvent. Now, non-aqueous solution. What is non-aqueous solution? When these solution have a solvent that is not water. See, when water is not used as a solvent or a solute, basically solvent, then that type of solution is known as a non-aqueous solution. In simple language, we can say that in order to prepare solution, when we use water, so that type of solution is known as a aqueous solution. And when we do not use water as a solvent to prepare solution, so that type of solution is known as a non-aqueous solution. So on the basis of water as the solvent, two type of solution is there, that is aqueous solution and non-aqueous solution. Now let's just see some other criterias on which basis solution are categorized or classified. See, on the basis of amount of solute added, means how much amount of solute is present in a particular solution, on that basis how many type of solution is there. So on that basis, basically three type of solution is there, that is unsaturated solution, saturated solution and supersaturated solution. Now let's just see what is unsaturated solution. Unsaturated solution, an unsaturated solution is one that can dissolve more amount of solute at a definite temperature. It means that we can still add more solute to the solvent. See, that we already know on the basis of the availability of solute in solvent, three type of solution is there, that is unsaturated solution, saturated solution and supersaturated solution. Now what is unsaturated solution? When we are able to add more amount of solute at a particular given temperature, so that type of solution is known as a unsaturated solution. Now saturated solution, when a solution is saturated, it can't hold or it can't able to add more amount of solute to the solvent, means we are not able to add more amount of solute in a particular solvent, so that time the solution is known as saturated solution. Just understand like this, a solution is said to be saturated when we can't add any more solute to the solvent at a particular given temperature. This means that the solution cannot dissolve any more solute at a definite temperature. See, it's very simple. In unsaturated solution, we are able to add more and more and more amount of solute at a particular given solution, at a particular given temperature. But in case of saturated solution, we are not able to add more amount of solute at a particular given temperature. So that type of solution is known as a saturated solution. Now up to this, might be it is clear that what is unsaturated solution and saturated solution. Now let's just see the other type of solution, that is supersaturated solution, means when the percentage of solute is much excess in comparison to the solvent, then that type of solution is known as a supersaturated solution. So what it is, let's just see. Supersaturated solution is one where the solute is present in an excess amount. That we already know by the name supersaturated, means the solution can hold the excess amount of solute in it. This solute is dissolved forcefully by raising the temperature pressure of the solution. These generally crystal out in the bottom of the method called crystallization. See, you just understand like this, ki just take a bowl and put on flame. After that you just keep adding the sugar. By the increase of the temperature, the more and more an amount of solute can dissolve in that particular bowl which contain a water in it. After some time, when all the water get removed, you will get the crystals, and that process is known as a crystallization process, and the formed solution is known as a supersaturated solution. So we can simply say that a supersaturated solution is a that type of solution in which the excess amount of solute is added forcefully by increase of temperature and pressure. Saturated solution is that type of solution in which we are not able to add more amount of solute at given or a particular temperature. An unsaturated solution is that solution in which we are able to add more and more amount of solute, but not in an excess. More and more amount of solute, but not in an excess at a particular temperature. So that type of solution is known as a unsaturated solution, saturated solution and supersaturated solution. So this is the second criteria on the basis of the presence of solute in solution. The solution is categorized in a form of unsaturated, saturated and supersaturated solution. Now on the basis of the concentration, how many types of solution are there? Let's just see. Before starting this, how to prepare saturated solution? Let's just see. Take 50 ml of water in 2 beaker. After that, add salt in 1 beaker with continuous stirring till no more salt dissolve in it. Okay. After that, what you will do? Just similarly add sugar in another beaker. You took 2 beaker. In first beaker, you added salt by continuous stirring until the whole salt not get dissolved and that solution is not able to hold more amount of solute. And the second beaker, you just add sugar by the continuous stirring, and after that what you will get till the no more sugar get dissolved, will get saturated solution of salt and sugar. If the mixture is heated, it dissolves more amount of solute, and on the increasement of the temperature, the solution become unsaturated. Okay, after that you will add, able to add more amount of solute in it, but after some period of time it also stop dissolving the more amount of sugar and salt. But if you keep that beaker continuous on flame, so it will add more and more amount of sugar and salt, and that solution becomes super saturated, and after some period of a time you will get crystals of sugar and salt, and that process is become crystallization process. Now let's just see the different type of solution on the basis of amount of solute added. This is the third criteria by which we can see the different type of solution. See, on the basis of amount of solvent, earlier we discussed the type of solution on the basis of presence of solute in solution. Now we will discuss the types of solution on the basis of solvent present in a particular solution. So on the basis of solvent, two type of solution is there, that is concentrated solution and diluted solution. When the percentage of solute is higher in comparison to solvent, when the percentage or when the amount of solute is higher in comparison to the solvent, so that type of solution is known as a concentrated solution. But when the amount of solute is less and the amount of solvent is higher, then that time it is known as a diluted solution. Let's just see. A concentrated solution has large amount of solute in it given solvent. For example, brine solution, orange juice, dark color teas, all are the example of concentrated solution. Similarly, diluted solution. A diluted solution has small amount of solute in a large amount of solvent. For example, induced salt solution, light color teas. In that, the percentage of solute is less in comparison to percentage of solvent. So, on the basis of amount of solvent, two type of solution is there, that is concentrated solution and diluted solution. The fourth criteria is on the basis of concentration of solute in two solution. Means when the two solution is having a same solute. So on the basis of the concentration of solute, how many types of solution is there? See, let's just consider a cell placed in a beaker, placed on the concentration of solute in two solvent. The cell in the beaker, we can have the following type of solution: isotonic solution, hypertonic solution and hypotonic solution. Now what is isotonic solution? These solution have the same concentration of solute in it. Means when both solute and solvent is having a same consistency, means both solute and solvent present in a equal amount, then that type of solution is known as a isotonic solution. Now what is hypertonic solution? When the solution contain higher percentage of solute and the percentage of solvent is less, or we can say that when a solution contain higher concentration of solute in comparison to less concentration of solvent, so that type of solution is known as a hypertonic solution. You will understand by the definition, the solution kept in a beaker has a higher concentration of solute in it. So water comes out from the cell and the solution is beaker causing the plasmolysis or the shrink. Simple is that when a solute is present in a higher concentration form and the solvent is present in a less concentration form, then the process of plasmolysis takes place and the solution become in a form of hypertonic solution. Now the last is hypotonic solution. When the concentration of solute is less and the concentration of solvent is high, so that type of solution is known as a hypotonic solution. So on the basis of the concentration of solute, three type of solution is there, that is isotonic solution, hypertonic solution and hypotonic solution. When both solute and solvent is having a same concentration, then that type of solution is known as a isotonic solution. When solute is having a higher concentration in comparison to solvent, then that time it is known as a hypertonic solution. And when the solvent is having, or the solute is having a less concentration in comparison to solvent, then that time it is called as hypotonic solution. Now let's just discuss how to find out, how to measure the concentration of any solution through different formulas, or what exactly the concentration means. Basically, the concentration means the strength and the power of a particular solution. So now we will study about concentration of solution. What exactly the concentration means and how we are able to calculate the concentration of solution. Let's just see. The concentration of solution is defined as the amount of solute present in given solvent or solution. Formula is given. The concentration of solution is equals to amount of solute upon amount of solvent. We will able to write down this formula like this: the amount of solute upon the amount of solution. Likewise, this also we are able to find out the concentration of any solution. Basically, the concentration of a solution can be expressed as mass by mass percentage, or as mass by volume percentage, or sometime volume by volume percentage. So with the help of mass by mass percentage, or mass by volume percentage, or volume by volume percentage, how we are able to calculate the concentration percentage or the percentage concentration percentage of any solution, let's just see. So with the help of mass by mass percentage, we are able to find out the concentration of any solution by applying this formula. So in that case, what we will do, we will just take a mass of a solute and a mass of a solution multiply by 100. So what we do, we just take mass upon mass percentage of solution equal to mass of solute upon mass of solution into 100. So by applying this formula, we are able to find out the concentration of solution in which both solute and solvent is present in a form of solid. So we will calculate their mass, and with the help of their mass, we will calculate the concentration of solution. Similarly, with the help of volume by volume percentage also, we are able to calculate the concentration of solution by applying this formula, that is volume of solute upon volume of solution into 100. Similarly, mass by volume, in that case, what we will do, we will do m upon V is equals to M of solute upon M of solvent and into 100. So when solute and solvent, when solute is present in a form of solid and solvent is present in a form of liquid, then we will apply mass by volume percentage formula in order to calculate the concentration of solution. Now let's just understand this formula with the example more clearly. Now starting with the first question, 0.5 gram of salt dissolve in 25 gram of water. Calculate the percentage amount of salt in the solution. So how you will write? First, in that you have to find out the amount of salt in a solution, and both solute and solvent is present in a solid state, or we can say that their mass is given. So what we do, first we will choose that what is solute is there and what is solvent is there. So here the mass of the salt present is 0.5 gram, which is a solute, and the mass of the solvent, which is a water, is 25 gram. So in order to calculate the amount of salt present in solution, we apply the mass upon mass percentage of solution, and by this we will calculate the amount of salt present in solution. So here by that formula, what we did, we just written the mass of the solute, which is 0.5 gram upon the mass of the solution, which is formed by the combination of solute and the solvent. The mass of the solute is 0.5 gram and the mass of the solvent, which is water, is 25 gram into 100. And after the calculation, we will get our answer, that is 1.96. Likewise, this many other examples are there by which we will understand the concentration of solution, how to find out the concentration of solution more clearly. So let's just see the second example or second question. Here the one urea, a solution of urea in water contains 16 gram on in 120 gram of solution. See, just read the question very carefully. It is written, a solution of urea in water, means urea is solute, and the amount of urea is given 16 gram, of it 120 gram of solution, and the amount of solution is given 120 gram. So in that question you are knowing about solute and solution. Amount of solute is given and amount of solution is given. You have to apply the mass upon mass percentage formula, and by this you are able to calculate the problem. So what you will do, you just write down like this, the mass of the urea upon mass of the solution into 100. The mass of the urea, which is a solute, is 16 gram, and the mass of the solution is given 120 gram. After solving this, you will get answer 13.33%. Now question number first and second is based on mass by mass percentage. Now let's just see some question based on volume by volume percentage, means in which both solute and solvent is given in a form of liquid and their volume is given. So let's just see. Question number 3, a solution has been prepared by mixing 5.6 ml of alcohol with 75 ml of water. Now calculate the percentage of alcohol in the solution by volume, means volume by volume percentage. Just read that question once again. A solution has been prepared by mixing 0.5 ml of alcohol, means alcohol is behave like a solute, with 75 ml of water. So water is behave like a solvent. We will apply the formula volume by volume percentage. We will take volume of solute upon volume of solution into 100. We just applied that formula, and after the calculation you will get answer 6.95. Let's just see some other example. Here question number 4 is given, a solution contains 30 gram of glucose, 20 gram of salt in 500 ml of water. Means a solution contains 30 gram of glucose, 20 gram of salt in 500 ml of water. Calculate the mass percentage of glucose. First, you have to calculate the mass percentage of glucose. Second is salt, means mass percentage of salt. The density of salt is given 1. See, in that solute and solvent is their unit is different. The unit of solute given in gram, but the unit of solvent is given in volume. So we will apply the formula of mass by volume percentage. So let's just start with the first to calculate the percentage of glucose by applying the formula. So what we will do? We will take the mass of glucose upon the volume of solution. Volume of solution, which is given 500 ml, and in that 30 gram of, you can say that glucose is added, 30 gram of glucose is added and 20 gram of salt is added. This is the mass of the solvent. A solution is formed by the combination of glucose, salt and water. So what, in order to find out the percentage of glucose, what we do? We just do take the mass of glucose, which is 30 gram, and after that the volume of solution, which is 550 ml, and after solving this you will get the mass percentage of glucose is 5.45%. Similarly, for salt you apply the same. The mass of salt is given 20 upon the volume of solution. Total mass of the solution is here, so here we will write volume. In place of mass, we will write volume. The volume of the solution is given 550 ml into 100, and on applying this we will get the mass percentage of salt is 3.64. mass percentage of glucose is 5.45, and mass percentage of salt is 3.64. Now let's just see more examples of based on the concentration of solution. See, the next example is, during an experiment the student were asked to prepare 10% solution of sugar in water. See, just read question very carefully. During an experiment the students were asked to prepare a 10% mass by mass percentage solution of sugar in water. Ramesh dissolved 10 gram of sugar in 100 gram of water, while Shikha prepared it by dissolving 10 gram of sugar in water to make 100 gram of solution. So what you have to take out from this question? So the first question is that, are the two solution of the same concentration, means both the solution are having same concentration or not? Second question is that, compare the mass percentage of the two solution. So the answer of the first question is that no, both the solution is not having same concentration. Why? See, Ramesh is dissolving 10 gram of sugar in 100 gram of water, means sugar behave like a solute and water behave like a solvent, and the overall amount of solution become 110 gram. But Shikha is preparing by dissolving 10 gram of solute in 100 gram of solution. 10 gram of solute in 100 gram of solution means the amount of solvent is not given in a case of Shikha. The amount of solution is only 10. That's why there is a difference in the concentration of the solution. Now let's just solve the problem, solution made by the Ramesh. In case of Ramesh, solute and solvent is given. So we will apply mass by mass percentage, that is mass of the solute upon mass of the solution. So mass of the solute is 10 gram, mass of the solvent is 100 gram, and mass of the solute is 10 gram. By the combination of solute and solvent, solution get formed, and the amount of solution become 10 upon 110 into 100 and you will get answer 9.09%. In case of Shikha, the mass of solute is given and the mass of solution is given. Simply apply the formula of mass by mass percentage, which is 10 upon 100 into 100 and you will get 10%. So the solution prepared by Sarika has a higher mass percentage than the percentage by prepared by the Ramesh. Likewise, this many numerical questions are there based on the concentration of solution which you people have to solve or which you people have to practice with the help of NCERT book and other side book. Likewise, this we will discuss more detail about the different type of matters and separating technique in our next video lecture. Thank you.